In the first module of the week 9 course, we are going to contemplate on different aspects in cybercrime. Look at the definition of cybercrime. This section provides an overview of cybercrime, of course. We'll see one after the other. The term cybercrime refers to an illegal act performed using a computer or any other electronic devices as a means or end to perform a violated act. Cybercrime is also known as computer crime, associated with any kind of offense towards using the systems or a particular network to entrust a crime. In a nutshell, any offense or illegal act committed using the electronic device is known as cybercrime. Cybercrime is a fast-growing area of crime, and so more and more criminals are exploiting the speed, convenience, and anonymity of the internet to commit a diverse range of criminal activities. With no borders, either physical or virtual, it causes serious harm and poses very real threats to the victims worldwide. Although there is no single universal definition of cybercrime, the law enforcement agencies generally make a distinction between two main types of internet-related crimes, namely the advanced cybercrime and cyber-enabled crime. What is an advanced cybercrime or high-tech crime? It is a sophisticated type of crime associated with the attacks against a computer hardware or a software. Whereas a cyber-enabled crime, many traditional crimes, of course, have been taken a new turn with the advent of the internet, such as the crimes against children, financial crimes and frauds, even sometimes the terrorism. Let's look at the various definitions available. I would like to quote here the Oxford Dictionary's definition of cybercrime. According to Oxford Dictionary, cybercrime refers to criminal activities carried out by means of a computer or internet. So, we are living in the modern world. So, the modern world today uses digital technology to connect individuals, businesses, financial organizations, and governments across political and cultural boundaries, providing several valuable paybacks to its users. Simultaneously, it provides a rich atmosphere for criminal activity too, ranging from vandalism and stolen identity to the theft of classified government information. If you look at the first cybercrime attempt towards cybercrime was recorded in the year 1820. Which does not consider the fact that the abacus was the most basic structure of a system from 3500 BC in India, Japan, of course, in China. In 1820, a loom was produced by Joseph Mary Jacquard, a textile manufacturer in France. This device allowed duplicate sequence of steps during weaving particular materials and created panic amongst Jacquard workers as their usual pay and source of revenue were endangered. They committed crime by introducing an interrupt activity, thereby discouraging Jacquard from further utilization of the novel equipment. This was, according to the record, the first cyber crime happened in the year 1820. There are several reasons that can be identified to describe why offenders commit cybercrimes. Some of them are for making quick money, for stealing a person's identity, for causing an individual to think what he or she believes in, for utilizing web activity at low cost, failing to adapt more expensive and less efficient law enforcement counsel, to utilize a technical framework, novel chances for performing illegal activities, to proceed wrong prosecution against authorized inquiry, to deny access to previous regulatory due to lack of reports and standards, to make personal identification highly complex, to restrict media coverage. Business cybercrimes are done by groups and not by an individual due to the lack of data storage capacity in comparatively small space. And finally, stealing the crime evidence. These are again some of the reasons identified behind the happening of cybercrimes. Cybercrimes are illegal and unfriendly act. Computer is a component of cyber criminal activity, which is either a tool or target of cybercrimes. They are committed in cyberspace with the aid of computer networking. It's a criminal activity carried out by utilizing systems for perpetuating further crime. They are committed against system or computer networking either by means of system itself or with some other tools as the object of the crime. Cyber crimes are taking place over the internet, resulting in data breaches. These activities are carried out for malicious purposes, causing damages to the system. Most of the time, cyber crimes are of great loss to the victims in terms of economic values. Various challenges are observed against cybercrime. Some of them are lack of traditions and awareness of cybersecurity at individual level as well as at the organization level, lack of skilled and experienced manpower to execute the counter processes. There is no particular email policy for the defense services, police and other security agencies' personnel. Cyber attacks have come not merely from terrorists but also from neighboring nations differing to the national interest. The minimum eligibility required for joining the police does not compromise or it does not comprise or mandate computer awareness, as they are the more inherent to cyber offense. The development of government is modified regularly by the pace of cyber knowledge, so that they do not have the ability to identify the cyber false origin. Lack of support in research and development in information and communication technology, in short ICT. Security services and law enforcement personnel are not equipped to notice high-tech offenses. Contemporary protocols are not self-adequate to conduct or observe a systematic approach towards handling the offenses. Finally, the financial report by the administration for training law enforcement, security personnel and investigators in ICT are less compared to other offenses. So these are the reasons why I should say cyber crimes are happening very widely across the nation or across the globe even. India witnessed more cybersecurity threats and incidents, approximately close to 27,000 incidents in the first half of the year 2017 itself. As per the report by Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, in short we call it as CERT-IN, the cybercrime incidents in India is noted like this. In the year 2014, there were 44,679 incidents. In 2015, 49,455 incidents. In 2016, 50,362 incidents. And 2017, 53,000 81 incidents. It shows that the trend an increasing trend in cybercrime incidents. Some of the important registered cases are the BPO Emphasis Limited, which is a case of information theft, and the DPS MMM case, and the Pranav Mitra's email spoofing scam. These are some of the very popular incidents recorded. Based on the Home Ministry statistics, nearly 71,780 cyber frauds were reported in the year 2013 itself, while 22,060 such cases were reported in the year 2012. So you can see that almost it's fourfold. So there have been 62,000 and odd incidents of cyber fraud till 2014. In the year 2013, a total of 28,481 Indian websites were slashed by different hacker groups across the world. The number of slashing events were 27,605 in 2012, and it is again 21,699 in 2011. Around 421,337 cases were registered beneath cybercrime related sections of Indian Penal Code in the year 2011, subsequently 12 and 13 respectively. So naturally we can observe the increasing trend in the cybercrimes. According to National Crime Records Bureau, in short we call it as NCRB, the cybercrime cases registered under Information Technology Act alone are like this. They are 2008, it is 288, 2009, it is 420, 2010, it was 966, 2011, it was 1791, 2012, it was 2876, and 13 was 4356. There has been more than 40% of annual increase of cybercrime cases registered within the country for the past 2-3 years. As per the data reported and tracked by CERTIN, a complete range of 3,08,371 and 78 government websites were hacked in the year 2011. Of course, we saw that. So, cyber attacks in the current era have become more specialized and concentrated in nature, targeting specific organizations, individuals, and governments. With more directed attack patterns, the impact of incidents and crimes have made alarming damages spanning financial losses, disruption of operational services, erosion of shareholder value and trust. So it's really important to understand how threats and attacks are constantly evolving, thereby creating an effective cyber resilient environment to withstand these testing times. Some of the important attack incidents are listed below, which will further throw light on the current situation. For example, malware constitutes the biggest share of cyber attacks faced by the organization. We saw the actual behavior, the characteristics, and how dangerous malwares are in our previous discussions, with 73% indicating it's as a menace, followed by 49% of spear phishing and 43% of ransomware attacks in the past years. In contrast to the organization's views, 73% of law enforcement authorities indicated that ATM card theft was the most commonly reported cyber crime to the cybercrime investigation cells, followed by phishing attacks, which is 47%, and the data theft, which is 40%. Moreover, 46% of the organizations believe that they are not adequately prepared in handling the ransomware attack, which is one of the upcoming major threats.